Guys, we're starting off on Raw. We're already on Raw. No Sunday Night Heat, no nothing. So Raw, April 1st week, 2002. We have a match against the Road Dog. Grandmaster Sexay versus Jeff Jarrett, and then Muta and Steven Richards taking on D'Lo Brown and Steve Blackman. Muta and Steven Richards on the same team seems fun. And it's the start of a new beginning in WWE. WWE Sports Entertainment will be more exciting than ever, and we promise to bring you that new thrill and excitement straight to your television sets. What does Flair want? Hey, Hall, I'm really glad you're here on Raw. You know, when I was the champ, I had to travel through some rough roads back in my day. But at the same time, I was able to accomplish my dreams and the dreams of many fans out there. I believe that you have that same vision. I'm expecting you to do well on Raw, all right? High expectations. Just jumps up out of nowhere and woos at us. What's wrong with you, Flair? Let's see what we got around here. Anybody lurking backstage? Doesn't seem like it. Oh, we got the Undertaker back here. We'll go talk to him. I wish that kept the audio clips too completely removed. Oh, that's right. They did get rid of everything, huh? And here comes the pain. That sucks, man.
Look out! The Undertaker is here!
What do you want to say to me? Are you mad or something? Why do you care? Can't wait to play this game again. Dude, this game is so much fun. Like, I keep going back to it every few months. I love it. Who the hell are you to ask me questions? What business is it of yours? What's wrong, Hall?
The Undertaker is
see your
one
fear?
Of the most intimidating and sadistic human beings to ever walk the face of the earth. I totally agree with you,
JR. You fear me. Ooh! Sucker punch from The Undertaker. Yeah, dude, you need a whole bunch of playthroughs to get everything. Like, all I got left are a few arenas and some attires. Like, all the important shit to me is already unlocked. That's all I was, like, really cared about. Let's try to get this show on the road. Grandmaster Sexay taking on Jeff Jarrett. Jeff Jarrett gets the win there. Comes our matchup against Road Dog. Yeah. Yeah, exactly. You just start unlocking a lot of them. Plus, or some of them you have to unlock via. Oh, no, never mind. Yeah, you just unlock them through progressing through the story. You don't have to unlock them after when you have the pay per view. You get to choose like the five cards or whatever. I don't think there's any wrestlers in there. I think it's just attires and like created moves and stuff like that. I hate that Scott Hall, like in the created guys, when you use the NWO stuff, they still come out in full color instead of black and white. That has always drove me crazy. Looks so bad. But oh yeah dude, I found all the formulas and everything online and just did what other people have been doing for years.
And the opponent,
I actually really like this one.
Mm-hmm.
Billy Gunn entrance works so good for him. So here we go, our first matchup. Off to a good start.
Fuck it.
Put it in the front instead of the back. Yeah. Should be able to do that.
What? What the hell is going on here?
Ah, shit. There we go. He always had something written on the back, but I think the actual NWO logo was on the front. I could be wrong, though. So I think the back was always the blood drip. It was on the front, yeah. I was about to say, are we gonna win from a backslide? Do it again. I think outsider. I want to say he had outsider on the back. Oh, what the hell? Hang on, I grab him right there.
No. Stop him out.
Bitch. You're wrong? Okay.
DDT.
I couldn't remember, man. He had Hall in the back. That makes sense, too. Yep. That's a... Oh, damn. I thought that was a new rope break. Nope. Road dive. Well, not just leave me alone. NWO in the front, Hall in the back. Okay. I'll fix that after stream. Get that going for the next time. I do not mind. Shit. Damn it. Quit knocking me outside the ring, asshole. Outsider's edge.
One, two, three.
Good first win to start off the season. Oh yeah, dude, that powerbomb hits the outsider's edge is so sick. So freaking good. Like, the only real powerbomb I like more than that one is probably the awesome bomb. Because that move was just deadly. Raw franchise is prepared to sign the free agent Stone Cold Steve Austin. Oh, and here comes McMahon. I'll tell you something. He wants an owner with leadership and management skills. Stone Cold will sign the contract to be exclusively on SmackDown. Sid's powerbomb was also another one I really like, because he just picks you up and then just drops your ass. No regard for your safety whatsoever. Just out there trying to murder dudes, and I loved it. Hey, thank you so much, Fanatic Gamer, for the follow. Much appreciated, dude. Welcome, welcome. Give you a hell yeah. Oh, hell yeah. I say no to him and yes to you, huh? Let me sign your contract. You too, huh? I don't know. I don't know why he doesn't. I have no clue, man. I was interested in both and I thought about it a lot. I've made up my mind. The deal is done. Vince, you know what? Today is April Fool's Day. Pushed it too early. Sorry. Ooh, at least we can see Flair get stunned. There we go. Steve Austin officially signed to Monday Night Raw. And then Blackman and D'Lo Brown defeated the Great Muta and Steven Richards. Time for April, week number two. Oh, hell yeah, dude. Watching all this kind of stuff was great back then. All right, we got Scott Hall taking on Ron the Truth Killings. Then we got a hardcore match, Grandmaster Sexy versus Dean Malenko. Then a six-man tag with Steven Richards, Terry Funk, and Mick Foley taking on Steve Blackman and Kai and Tai. That is an awesome fucking main event. I'm not gonna lie, dude. Steven Richards and Funk and Foley taking on Blackman and Kai and Tai? Hell yes. All in. ECW versus WWF? Hell yes. Exactly. Today is so bad. Meh. It might be, like I said, I don't really watch the current stuff a whole lot. Just mainly the pay-per-view premium events or whatever the hell they're called. Some PLEs. Yeah, same. Like, it depends on what the card is. I mean, if the card looks like shit, I don't even bother. It just kind of just like, eh, whatever. Mm. Christian has such an amazing freaking theme in this game, dude.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Way to the ring, Joker.
Why are you asking me, dude? I don't fucking know. I don't know why their booking sucks. I don't fucking work for them. I have no clue, dude. Like, everybody's got their opinions on it and shit, but I have no idea. All jobber in WWE, if you say so, man. If you say so. Why did I do this? I didn't mean to. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to turn WWE into boring booking horseshit. My apologies. Thought I was doing good. All right, let's beat up on Ron Killings real quick. Out the face. Is Kay quick in a game? I don't think so, no. I wish he would have, man, just so we can get the Get Rowdy theme. That's the other showcase we need. We need the William Regal and we need the Kay quick R-Truth showcase. It was in WWF Raw? The Xbox PC one? Or a different one? Oh shit. I didn't know that. That's awesome. Did we get Road Dogg in that game too with the same what the hell is it called? The overalls. Playing the first Raw for a little bit. Wasn't a big, big fan of it, so I didn't play it a whole lot. I like Raw 2 a lot, though. That one I really enjoyed. The fact that you can change up the, you can actually edit the some of the guys. Like, change their gear and stuff like that. Or gear colors, at least. Nah, what rumor about Jim Ross? No, if no Road Dogg? Damn. Gave birth to a dead pig, god damn it. I knew it was gonna be something silly. Like, I don't even know why I bothered asking. Remember that old WWE Rock got to watch? You can still watch it all, dude. It's on Peacock or WWE Network. But it's never gonna be like it was. That'll never ever happen. It's completely different. Different generation, different everything. Road Dogg left January 01? Okay. When did Raw come out about? Oh no, shit, it came out like 02. I think. Shit. It's always because of drugs. Another win for Scott Hall. The lone NWO member. Too much doggy style. Road Dogg was good at what he needed to do. That's about it, man. He could sell and he could talk. That's all he needed really to do. Let Billy Gunn get in there and kick some ass in the ring. So Grandmaster Sexy defeated Dean Malenko and WWF defeated ECW, which sounds about right. Move on to week number 3. Staying on Raw. Raw is boring. That's true. Raw's too damn long, dude. 3-hour Raws are just way too fucking long anymore. Here we go. Scott Hall versus Ron Killings in a table match. Terry Funk versus D'Lo Brown. And Steve Austin, Undertaker, and Steve Blackman in a triple threat match as your main event. Yeah, dude, I can't do 3-hour Raws every single week. That shit's way too much. It has been for a long time. Like, even the pay-per-views get boring after a while. It's like, 3 hours is a long fucking time. Oh, yeah, no, 3-hour Nitro was just as long, too. But, like, for whatever reason, they were, like, fun. It's just like, bam, bam, bam. So I was a big WCW guy. I watched Nitro more than I watched Raw back in the day. Because I love Lucha Libre style. The Mexican luchadors and all that kind of stuff, I've always loved that. So seeing them was always fun. But the main events always sucked.
Taker is one of the most
dangerous. Damn good point, Captain. That's a damn good point, dude. It's very predictable and formulaic. Growing up in Jersey, I was programmed to be a WWF guy. That makes sense. You again? Let me ask you a question. Are those your real teeth? Would you like to keep your teeth? It's such a weird question. Go ahead if you think you can.
The Undertaker said
If you can't respect yourself, then no one else will respect you. Why are you so mean to Scott Hall? I'll teach you some respect. I'll teach you what respect means tonight. Dude, you've already got... will you teach me to football? Yeah, we're going to go ahead and get the hell up out of here. Bye! Later, yo! Can't turn around fast enough to get him. Turn around. Oh shit. Okay, good. Alright, enough of that. We're not going to be able to hit him. I'm gonna read the chat like super far behind. See, favorite wrestler was Claudio after 2014. I couldn't watch him anymore in WWE. Yeah, dude, it's some of the guys, they just couldn't find anything fun for him or good for him at all. And Claudio's a perfect example of that. He's so fucking good, but just nothing at all. Get back to the ring.
To be honest with you, Keith, the Undertaker is the most evil hardcore champion I've ever seen. I totally agree with you, JR.
Did he cut their spot before that? Yeah. I like Gunther, though. Our superstars today are too corny and soft with Mike. That's because they're way too scripted. Yeah, like they're not allowed to really go off like they were able to, like, allowed to last time. It's a different culture nowadays, so you can't just say whatever the hell you want on TV anymore. That's the main difference why people don't like it. It's like, well, they don't understand that. Just like you don't hear the same type of shit you did on TV shows 10, 15 years ago. It sucks. But it happens. Nope. Oh, man, a slam. Shouts out to Tess. Ow. What the fuck? I don't know why you say, like, there's no more mature fans in the audience, dude. There's lots of full-grown men and women in the audience, for sure. Like, they show them all the fucking time. Oh, there I go. Oh yeah, dude, that's 100% fact, their captain. Like, the death of WCW was the worst thing to happen for WWE for the last 20 years. They just showed crybaby fans that cry for nothing. Dude, half the fucking roster, like, women's roster cry for fucking nothing. Everybody's favorite female wrestler, Sasha Banks, literally cries after every fucking match she's ever had. And it's like, you blame the fans for that? No, dude. She's garbage. They're there, they're just not the targeted audience anymore. Exactly. Exactly. The target audience are the kids. Has been for a while. But yeah, dude, WCW going out and they're not, like, no longer being a, like, an actual competition for wrestling, or for WWE rather, was the worst thing to happen, because then they didn't care anymore. We're the only show in town, so it doesn't matter anymore. As much as TNA tried and a few others tried, it just was never going to happen. Just like AEW, it's like, yeah, they can compete money-wise, but they're just not gonna, they're not as big. They're not a worldwide phenomenon yet. They're still small enough to fail, whereas WWE's not. They're way too big to fail. You miss the Nitro Girls? Hell yeah. We all miss the Nitro Girls for sure. More magic moments. That's fair. I mean, they're still there. It's just not as magical because you may not like the guys anymore. So hot. Want to touch the hiney.
It's not over yet.
Yeah, let me sit there quote Billy Madison thinking you're going to get away with that. You don't care for women's wrestling? I don't care for most women's wrestling. I won't lie about that. There's still some out there that I do enjoy. Some women's wrestlers, but for the most part, it's pretty bad. Yeah, exactly. Like, you get it, it's just not your thing. That's perfectly fine.
That was a close call. No,
yeah, there's definitely some good ones out there. It's just harder to find sometimes. So you want gimmick matches. That's what it is. You don't like want like better wrestling. You just want like the gimmick matches. That's what you miss the most. And like, there's nothing wrong with gimmick matches. Obviously, I've said it many times. I'm an ECW guy growing up, but wrestling can be more than just gimmicks. They're not real athletes today. Dude, they're better athletes than they were during the Attitude Era, for sure. Like, calling them not real athletes is such an insult to anyone who's ever stepped in the ring, for sure. Like, that's such an insult, man. Good wrestling match is a normal match. I hate gimmick matches for the most part, except when the story calls for it. 100%. 100% agree with you, Captain. Yeah, the matches are very boring for the most part. It's because you gotta... It's such a three-act play every single match, and it goes on way too long. Like, every match shouldn't be 15, 20 minutes long. It really, really shouldn't. Like, I miss the 3-4 minute squash matches, or just quick back and forth, get in there, hit the hits, get out of the ring. Like, the fact that there's a commercial break in every match is fucking infuriating. I can't stand that anymore. I've never liked it. Way too many false finishes. Yes, 1000% agree. 1000% agree, man. Yep, and then certain moves that are badass and they should be like, they end everything, like the Canadian Destroyer. It gets so super overused that it doesn't mean shit anymore. Oh yeah, dude, AJ Styles is one of the best in the world right now. By far. AJ's the man. It's like fall finishes should be saved for matches, like title matches or semi and tournament finals. Yeah, like really important matches. But just a throwaway fucking AJ Styles versus Cedric Alexander on Raw, there should never be one of those there. Exactly. It should be like at a crucial part of the match where it's like he's been beating the hell out of him, hits the finish, like gets a real close finish, 1-2, 2.9 kick out. Like, yes, it means something. Get the crowd to pop. Too many interruption, too many DQ. Dude, all the Attitude Era was interruptions. That's all they had back then. Watch any Raw from 98 to like 2003. Every single match has a fucking interruption, bro. That's all they were. Deserved superstar is a champion? Maybe, maybe not. That's debatable. Sometimes. Yeah. Sometimes they ended the show that way. Other times it was just... They just did it. The big fuck... I love the fuck fest at the end, dude. Those were always great. Because everybody goes in there and it's just a finisher fest. Those will never not be fun for me. Let's see if we can end off killings here quickly. Nope, maybe not. Here, bitch. Got him. Move that tight thing. it was a crowd go home happy. What I always liked is that like they would have the big fuck finish, the show would end, and then the live crowd get like a six man tag with those same six guys or whatever. That was perfect. It's the way to do it. But now they do it so often to enhance a rivalry. True. Yeah, they should only do the big fuck finishes for like the main event storylines. I don't need to see the opening match have a fucked finish. That's weird. Like, it doesn't make sense. You can have them lose. It's okay. There's a lot about wrestling nowadays that you can critique, and there's a lot you have to sit there and give credit for as well. It's like, production wise, it looks great. It's beautiful looking. Too many worst heel turn. Fans have no sense. Yeah, that's true. There's a lot of heel turns. I agree. Certain guys, they just don't know what to do with them. They're like, well, let's try him face and he doesn't get over. Let's try him heel and he doesn't get over. So it's like, well, what do we do now? Let's send him back to face. Let's send him back to heel. It's weird, man. You gotta let the, I think the wrestlers should have more say-so in what happens with their careers. They'd be able to go out there and cut the promos that they feel comfortable with, that make sense to their character. Oh yeah, dude, no, there's no such thing as a true heel anymore. There really isn't. And I hate that. I loved true heels. Like, I want a guy who I can't fucking stand, and I want to see him get his ass kicked every single week. Shane Douglas, best heel of the 90s and 2000s. I put him up there. I definitely put him up there, man. I think Vince McMahon is the biggest heel and the best heel of the 90s and 2000s. But Shane Douglas, definitely up there for sure. Yeah, McMahon, for sure. That's my number one. Even all time, I think McMahon's the greatest heel, because nobody liked him at all when he was full-blown doing it. Let's talk to Taker again. Why not? I like Shane, but he would bitch about... But he did. All he did was bitch about Flair his whole career. Yeah, that's true. That is very true. He did bitch about Flair a lot.
Undertaker is here.
A lot of time it was funny, though. I forget it. Pissed me off. Boom! Punched in the head again. Dick Flair. Gotta love him calling him Dick Flair. What annoyed me, though, is like at the end of WCW's run, he was like kind of Flair's little buddy. Storyline-wise, it's like, you fucking hate him. You made a career about hating Flair. Why are you guys on the same side? So dumb. Angle, Jericho, Christian, Triple H. Yeah, four greats. But four guys that also were super cheered while they're trying to be heels. So I'm going to call any of those four true heels. Triple H probably the closest. What, no entrance for Liger? What the hell? I give Jushin Liger his credit, man. He deserves a full-blown entrance. Yeah.
Fuck it. Exciting.
Yep. Oh, dude, Liger, it's so good. But, like, they had, like, all the parts pretty much already pre-programmed in the game, so it wasn't too difficult. Yeah, he looks incredible. Jericho and Angle still had their fans due to their charisma and in-ring work. Exactly. Triple H was just hated by everybody. Still is for the most part. Like, a lot of people don't like him when they think about him wrestling. I was always a big Triple H guy, though. I won't lie. I didn't really like DX a whole lot, but I always liked Triple H. I was always a big, big fan of his. Just murdering fucking Liger here with the sledgehammer. Oh yeah, for sure. Pre-02 to 03, Triple H was fantastic. Especially after he got with Stephanie. He was the biggest piece of shit. I loved it. Like, I still go back and watch it and be like, man, ugh. You think 2000 was your favorite friend? Good choice. Oh, yeah. Let's end Liger real quick. Oh, shit. Maybe not. Yeah. Here we go. Outsider's Edge. Dude, Cactus Jack Triple H at Rumble 2000 is one of my favorite matches ever. In fact, Rumble 2000 as a whole, the whole pay-per-view is one of my like top three pay-per-views ever. I love Rumble 2000 so much. Like, even with the beauty contest, it's still so entertaining, so much fun to watch. Three for you, hell yeah, man. It's so good. And then fucking Taka Michinoku breaking his face in the match, in the Rumble match. It's awesome. And then Lawler laughing at him the whole time. That pay-per-view is so good. Like, that slow-mo replay that they do, where you just see him go down, hit, and then, oh, is burned into my brain forever. I'll never forget that. It was so funny. We have 2000, my favorite year for them. Their creative was on an all-time high with Russo leaving, and their in-ring product was getting great thanks to Eddie, Angle, Jericho, and Benoit. Lawler constantly called him Chinese, though. I forgot that he constantly called him Chinese. That's right. Oh, yeah, dude. The last years of WCW were the best years for WWF. Without question, man. Without question. We got here at Backlash, we got a Fatal 4-Way, Hurricane, Fred Durst, Chris Jericho, Funaki, TLC title, Tornado Tag, Lance Storm, Christian versus the Hardys, and then a ladder match, RVD versus Kurt Angle. I think all three of those are title matches. We'll find out, though. With this aggression era, I liked it for other reasons. Like, it was really good, seeing like the whole new era of wrestlers coming in, especially around SmackDown. Or SmackDown at the time, yeah. SmackDown at the time when you had fucking Edge, Eddie, Taker, Booker, all those dudes. Fucking nuts. Rey, Batista. Fuck, man. SmackDown was stacked. Ruthless Aggression is your favorite? Nice. I'm an attitude guy. You know, I'm going to start telling people I was a new generation guy just to see their reaction. It's like, yeah, I liked it better when Bret Hart was there. That was my guy. Everyone back then was so over. Like, the Hardys were getting pops, almost Rock and Austin levels. Oh, for sure, dude. All the tag teams were nuts. Tag team was so good. Cruiserweight Championship match. Hurricane, Fred Durst, Jericho, and Funaki. Probably gonna be Jericho just because he's the only not created guy. Yep. I don't know how Jericho's a cruiserweight though in this game. It's annoying. Tag Team Championship, TLC Tornado Tag Style, Storm and Christian versus the Hardys. Party Boys get the win. And your main event, ladder match for the IC title, RVD and Angle. What's up, X-Pac? How you doing, bud? Angle getting the win there. At Backlash. We're not even booked. See, I liked it better than when, like, because tag teams were actual tag teams. Like, they looked like each other. Like, they were a tag team unit at all times. It wasn't just two random dudes and they became a tag team. Like, I never liked that at all.